Well, good afternoon, morning, ladies and gentlemen, mothers, fathers, daughters, sons, brothers and sisters. This is a social event here for the AOR GT3 League. It is at the national version of the Donington Park Raceway. I am King-Kodiak. I will be your commentator for this evening's race. As per usual, you see us at the beginning of the, or near the beginning of the 15-minute qualifying session. We currently have 16 drivers. Some people just beginning to make their way onto the circuit. As you can see, it is foggy. Now, I did have a few laps around this circuit, and it is hard as hell to see. How little visibility you see, for instance, we're just watching Konos here in the M3. That is it. That's all you've got. AJ has joined us, only 17 drivers now here on the field. So we have Konos in the M3. We have Papand in the roof. We have Attila. Is he in the roof again? Yes, he is. Wycombs in the roaring Bentley. Centro. What is Centro in? He's in the Mercedes. He is in the AMG Mercedes. Mini Black. Camera's confused. Mini Black, I believe, is in Z4. Yes, he is. Infected Space in his beloved Corvette. Dangerous Ginetta in his namesake Ginetta. Ginetta should do pretty well here, it not being a particularly power-orientated circuit. Vice Guy in his roof. Me, not going anywhere. Franco Droz, the only Aston Martin runner currently in the field. Andrex UK in the M3, just coming around to start his timed lap. Andrex again, apparently. Tipple, out there somewhere. Usually in the roof. Yes, he is. There he goes. Paradiski in his Z4. Hey ho, Jack. Welcome back to you. You are in the roof. Ruby in the McLaren. Kaki in the orange McLaren, and there is AJ in just leaving the pits, trying to find a particular spot. As we have some laps beginning to be set, then we have Papand, Andrex, Tipple jumping into the mixture as well. So Papand, Tipple, Andrex, Centro, Ahojek, Wycombs, and Goenos setting a lap at the moment. What times are we seeing? 103.969 by Papand. You have no idea how difficult that is. Fog is this thick. Tipple, 104.984. So see a second between these two expert drivers. Andrex, 105.187. Centro, 105.324. Where is he? Here he is. Is he completing a lap? Oh, he's gone too deep into the S's. And he's now facing where he has just come from. Ahojek in the roof. 105.593. Fifth position. Papan's completed another lap. Oh, Mini Black bangs in the second time, going the wrong way down the field. Mini Black, 104.964. Still a second between first and second. What a stunning lap by Papan. Done to see some other laps on the board then. Tipple, as we've seen. Andrex, Centro, Ahojek, Paradiski, 105.640. In his Z4, he's there somewhere having a fight with Dangerous Ginetta already. Koenos just coming to complete his lap. What does he do? 105.805, his current time. Does he improve? Answer is, the line is a long way down the straight. He does. Up two places, 105.525. The start-finish line is a long way down that straight. Ahojek then just freshly demoted with a 105.593. Paradiski coming out for another run. 105.640. So this pack in the midfield, or the current midfield, fairly closely, very close in time. It's Grobe in the McLaren, 106.805. Where is he? He is coming up to the S's just to complete his lap. We've got several other people. Khaki bangs in the pole time. What does he achieve? 102.949. And oh, that's Andrex UK in the M3 parked on the side of the track. Look at that. Let's just have a looky then at the time difference. That's a second. Whoops. That's okay, you can't really help that in the pits in this game. You drive through people. So Khaki, a second, almost exact, ahead of Papand. Goodness me. Absolutely unbelievable. Now, Donington National is a pretty short circuit, certainly compared to the Nürburgring. Everything is short compared to the Nürburgring, let's face it. Papin 2. Franco Droz, what an effort by the Aston driver. 104.826, slots into third place. See how his car always seems to twitch around. I must ask whether he's a keyboard driver. See, it always seems to be twitching around like that. Excellent effort. Currently fourth. Mini Black. On a time lap then in the Z4. 104.964. Oh, nope, he's in fifth. Andrew 2K, we just saw parked on the side of the road, so I'm assuming he's then on an outlap with a 105.126 in the M3. Infected space in the Corvette. 105.215, just been demoted by PNK, who's just slotted into ninth place in the Z4 with a 105.133. And we have another joiner. It is Rygor has jumped onto the server, I believe. Welcome, welcome, welcome. 19 drivers then. Infected space, we've just mentioned in the Corvette. Centro, the camera's not changing. Let's try that again. There is Centro in the Aston, just crossed the line to start another time lap. Currently 11th, 105.324. Koenos in the pits. M3? Yep. 105.525. Paradiski just coming to the end of his lap in the Z4. Does he improve with a 105.640? Does he go up the field from 13th? Answer is... what an improvement that was! 104.935 jumps up to 7th, and Papand and Tipple swapping positions. I've just noticed near the top of the field. Papand with a 103.630. He gets within a second of the mighty Khaki at least. Still a bit of a gap there for Papin to overcome. Tipple has just been demoted to third place with his 103.882. Let's have a look for... oh, Attila has set a time that I didn't spot, so apologies there. Currently fourth with a 104.541. Hey, Hojack. A very roof-heavy field at the moment. 104.756. Franco Droz, you mentioned. There's Paradiski, Mini Black, Andros UK, PNK, Infected Space, Centro. Oh, Centro's just coming to the end of his lap. Let's have a look. Does he improve? He does not. 12th with a 105.324. Kovanos. Oh, Groby. Groby's gone wrong at the S's there, so he's waiting for an opportunity to get going again. He's going to have to do... he's basically going to have to do an outlap because he's going to be starting that lap really, really slow. The line is there, you've just seen him cross. So he's going to have to basically do an essentially an outlap and a timed lap again. But he has got time to do. It's a relatively short lap, as you can see. Low 1 minute. We have 6¾ remaining of this session. Vice Guy in his roof. Currently 15th, 106.91. Wycombs in his Bentley, 107.363. Where is he? Let's have a look where he is. He is coming up to the coppice turn, which is the penultimate turn. There he comes. Long right-hander onto the Dunlop straight. So while this is as long a straight, it's the only real straight there is in this circuit, the Dunlop straight and the weak cross straight, which is the start finish straight. Here he comes through the S's with who's that? It's Mini Black behind him. Does Wycombs improve from 107.363 and 16th position? Answer, he does not. So either... oh, yes, he does. What am I saying? Up to 5th position with a 104.684. And that probably is Wycombs' day done. If he comes up quickly, he can get another time lap run. But what an effort. Oh, he's already demoted. Already demoted by... was it Attila? No, Attila's just coming to finish his lap. Does he improve? No. It was AJ. I missed that update on the board there. AJ jumps into fourth position with 104.001. Superb effort. I'm just going to double check my windows here. We have 5 minutes and 20 to go. Let's double check that all is well. Apologies if this is going to cause... sorry, I seem to be having a bit of trouble here. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to see if I can resolve it. Okay, so I'm going to try and get... apologies, ladies and gentlemen, having some technical difficulties here. But hope to get sorted before the race begins. Yep, that seems to have done it. Right, okay. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I know that the recording has stopped. But all should be well in the next few moments. So I'm just going to play about with my windows again to get myself back up and running. There we go. We should. Oops. No. Near. It was. Thought I had that sorted, but not quite. Nearly there. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Highly professional of me, I know. Hello, Enzo. Why are you not joining us on the race circuit, dear boy? Where is your mighty Aston, may I ask? It was actually thanks to you, Enzo, that made me realise the stream wasn't working. Don't know why. I have told OBS to get the stream going, but never mind. It is now running thanks to you. Taking a quick drink there. Okay, so we have 3 minutes left of the qualifying session. Let's have a quick look at where we stand. Khaki, currently on the top with 102.949. The only driver to break 103. Papan, oh, that was a hell of a thump. Papan coming out again. He's leaving that very late. He has got time to do it. And out comes Papan then in his roof. Currently second, 103.478. Tipple holds the third position. He's also in a roof. The camera can't find him. Is he in the pits? Answer. No, he is out on circuit. Just the camera getting very, very lost. Tipple in third. I'm going the wrong way through the field. AJ in his roof, coming down to the S's to complete his time lap. Look at how close the field is. We have 20 cars on circuit then. When the circuit is only that long, it's never usually a massive gap between the vehicles. So AJ on a time lap named, hoping to improve on his fourth place, 103.968. Attila is in the pits. His day is done. He will not have time to complete an outlap and a flying lap. Mini Black currently on circuit. Is that... That's Khaki, who we've also seen in the pits as well. So those two are done. Mini Black is on circuit. Where is he? He's on... Not the last straight? No, he's... that's Coppice. That's Coppice. He's just coming around onto the Dunlop straight. So, the Z4 of Mini Black coming to the end of his... assume it's a time lap. It could be an outlap. If it is an outlap, he does have time to complete a time lap. If it is a timed one, he has time to do another. Round he comes then onto the Wheatcroft straight. Does he improve on sixth position? He does not. So, but it looks like he's continuing. So, Mini Black on his way for another time lap. We are now out of time for people to start a time lap. Franco Droz, his day is done in his Aston. 104.949. Someone smacked into the wall, and that looks like Rygor coming out in his Bentley. I think it's Rygor in the Bentley. Centro is done. He's in eighth position with a 104.558, as is a Hojek. What is I think, is he a roof? Yes, he is. That's 104.584 in 9th position. Wycombs in his Bentley, 104.684 in 10th. Paradiski having a practice pit stop in 11th, 104.935. Andrew GK in the M3, he has done 12th position, 105.022. And the camera hasn't changed on who we're actually looking at. Let's try that again. Groovy in his McLaren, he's done in 30th, 105.040. BNK 14th, 105.133. Is anyone actually on circuit at the moment? One. In fact, he's based in the Corvette 15th with a 105.215. Rygor in the roof. It wasn't in the Bentley as I thought. 105.44 in 16th. Koenos in his M3, 105.525 in 17th. It's Wycombs that was the Bentley driver. In where is he? I've lost him. Has he dropped? No, he is there somewhere. There he is. At the very last second, he must have jumped up to 10th position. So that is your qualifying order done then, in the order in which you've seen. A driver I haven't yet mentioned is Steph, who is in 20th position in the order. Now, just to highlight how difficult it is to see in these conditions. We have the usual 5 minute practice session, and as has become small tradition, because I haven't always done it, I'm going to have a bit of a drive, which always causes a giggle because I am hopeless. So out I come in the Bentley. It's of course a left turn out of the pits, which is fairly unusual. And out I come then onto Redgate, and there's no way in hell I can commentate and drive at the same time. But you can see for yourself just how difficult it is. I still can't see the apex. There it is, and I've already gone wide. That's how hard it is to see the apex. Now, of course, the cars have lights on, and I've spun it already, as I tend to do, giving it too much gas. This is a pretty bumpy circuit, and that's... I didn't see who that was that went past me. No. Of course, I spin again. How very true, Enzo. Where's those big rally fog lights when you need them? Yeah, but all that would do is light the fog up in a bright white haze of, as someone said, as Paradiski said, milk. It would be like trying to drive through a blancmange, basically. Up the hill then, blind right-hander. Now, I did actually have a few laps in the free practice session before qualifying, and I spent the vast majority of it getting blue flagged and therefore stopping and getting out of everybody's way. Here are the S's, which of course I'm taking way too slowly. Now, highly unusually for these amusing practice sessions of mine, I've actually finished a lap, as you can see. Novel. There's the finish line, and I've got two drivers coming out ahead of me. It's not likely that I'm going to catch them, as I've gone wide at Redgate yet again. Very, very bumpy, which unsettles the car, and I go and break one of the distance boards again. Let me go back to the only place in which I belong, to sit in the commentary position. But there you go, that just goes to show how difficult it is to see in these conditions. I'll switch to the external camera. It's not much easier for me to see from this position either. But there we go, that is the racing condition that the drivers find themselves facing. It is also, there's the pause I've just flattened a few moments ago. It's also what the drivers will be facing 60 laps of. Very true, Enzo. I was wondering how much I'd be able to see from the stream, but we can see enough. You can see a vague silhouette of a car and some lights to hopefully be able to... That's a little unfair. You can actually see the cars just about. But if I just jump on board, if I get the right camera, there you go. That is the bumper cam. You can see how difficult it is to see. Hello, is Neptune. Hello, sir. And why is your Aston not on the field either, young man? A little bit late now. It's 1 minute 15 of the pre-race session to go. And why aren't you out here? Let's see, Cohen asked, whoops. Getting the S's all wrong, as I did earlier as well. The fog. Yeah. It's a bit of a pig. I was wondering exactly that. Hello, Yuri Jansen. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. I think you're right, actually. I think this would be considered a tad dangerous if the fog was actually this thick. But there we go. Getting the last few chips down my throat before we get underway, as I don't think I'm going to have much opportunity to eat during the race. It is such a short circuit, there's only 10 turns, we're less than 2 miles involved in the circuit itself. And that is the end of the pre-race warm-up then. Ah, have to take a glug of drink. 10 seconds then until this race gets underway. Gentlemen, please tell me how the stream is sounding. Please tell me how it's looking, as this is the first time of officially streaming the race under these new settings I've tried. Well, that looked... you could certainly see a lot from there. Now, I'm going to hold station just in case we have any ghost car situations. So stick my foot on the brake there. Oh, no, that goes backwards. You can tell I use an auto gearbox. Right, stand still. Right, so usual rolling start conditions then. Ah, hello, Yuriznikov. Hello and welcome. I'm just going to double check to see if there's any ghost car situations going on. I don't think we've had any disconnections, so... doesn't look like anybody's been jumping out of the way of an invisible car. And that'll be it. That's no one for me to push out of the way, so let's get up at the top of the field, shall we? So then Kharki leads the way. Thank you, Neptune. It's very much appreciated. Kharki then leads the way in the McLaren, with Papin in the roof second, and Tipple in the roof in third. Doesn't look like Tipple has his lights on. That's going to be interesting, especially as he's in a silver, well, a dark silver roof. Oh dear. I hope he gets his lights turned on at some stage. AJ in the same colour roof, and the camera's looking the wrong way. Come on, camera. Camera! There we go. I'm not no way going to get through the entire field, but you can see the overlay for yourselves. You can see who is in what position. As we are forming up now. Where are they? Is that coming up to... Yep, so they're on the Dunlop straight, just waiting for Kharki to floor it. And is he going? Is he going? No, he's still holding on. He's leaving this very late. Cheeky little monkey, come on. He's going to gun it in the S's, isn't he? No, he's still holding on. He's still waiting. Interesting. Why is he waiting so long, I wonder? He's really is hanging this out. You've got certainly Papin and Tipple ready to go, and away goes Kharki, finally. We are underway as Kharki comes out. We have a lot of banging around going on further down the field. Oh, goodness me, that's a roof in the wall already. Who's that falling through the order? It's AJ. AJ falling through the order, and he's still going on, still with no lights on. Infected Space has fallen down the order as well. Oh dear, terrible starts for those two. Jump back up to the top of the field then as Kharki has gone underway then. The McLaren beginning to build up a bit of a lead between him and Papin. Paradiski having a great start in, what's that, in sixth position. If the camera would pick him up there. Where is he? Paradiski. There he is in the Z4. Oh, lovely move on Franco Troes there. Lovely. Franco Troes got a bit of a tank swapper on there. Paradiski making the most of that. Aho Jack is falling foul to Groby. Oh, and that's... and as AJ in Infected Space having a bit of a battle between themselves at the back there. And that's Groby coming under pressure from Aho Jack. Aho Jack getting that position. Oh, he's overshot it into the S's. Oh, someone else has. Oh, an impact. Oh, Aho Jack has hit. That's an M3 that says it. Look at this. How am I going to commentate on this? There's so much going on there. And that's Wycombs is just slowly getting back underway in the Bentley. Who was out of the back? It's Infected Space. Oh, goodness me. Infected Space coming off definitely worse for wear in that particular melee. Now, again, remember the damage is off on this particular race. So, oof indeed, Neptune. So, of course, no damages can be caused here. And AJ getting through there on Wycombs, I think. Oh, and Steph, I beg your pardon. So, Steph is also a Bentley driver. Oh, and that's an M3 is getting a bit. There's that Koenos that's had a bit of a tank slapper on. Well held there. As he's currently chasing Dangerous Janetta. Let's head back up to the top of the field then as Kharki, unsurprisingly, is building a bit of a lead for himself at the front from Papin as Kharki comes to complete another lap. They have 60 laps to complete on this tiny little circuit. So Kharki currently needs Papin from Tipple. Less than 3 seconds separates the top three, and that's Koenos and AJ having a bit of a battle there. Oh dear, that looks like a cut penalty there for PNK and Koenos. PNK and Rygor, beg your pardon. So those who had a cut penalty and that allowed Wycombe to come through, is he going to be able to claim both of them into the red gate? Not quite. He's throwing to 16th position ahead of Weigel, but Weigel might name that one up. No, it looks like the Bentley's going to have that position to himself. Let's resume what I was saying back at the front there. We've just seen Khaki come through shot, and the camera is in the wrong place again. Oh dear, looks like I'm going to be having arguments with the camera all race long. Here is Khaki. That's the final turn. Coppice is coming around. Papin is second. Tipple third. So McLaren roof. Oh, three roofs in the top four. Attila is holding off Parandiski, who's had a great start. That's Mini Black getting a great run on Franco Droz. Camera, I think, is looking slightly in the wrong place. Oh, and that's Parandiski putting pressure on Attila there, as we just seen in the S's. We can see Groby getting all sorts of pressure from Andrich UK for eighth position here. McLaren and M3 fighting all the way down the red gate. McLaren still holds their position. Oh, Andrich looks like he was going to go a little bit deep there, but managed to hold on to the line. Oh, is he going to go for an inside maneuver on the McLaren? Come on, camera keeper. Yes, he does. He gets a great run through Redgate, through Hollywood, through the Craner curves, and takes eighth position from Groby. Goodness me, upfield, action up and down the field here, as we have Centra then that is straight on the back of Groby for ninth position. Ahojack 11 in the roof, I believe. Vice Guy 12th in the roof. He's had a pretty decent start. Wycombs has not had a good start though in the Bentley. He has got Dangerous Ginetta and Rigor all over his tail. The camera is again looking in the wrong place. There we go, we are underway again. So Wycombs, Dangerous Ginetta, Rigor, that chain of three. Oh, and that's PNK getting pushed wide by Rigor. Through the S's then, you're never going to get too wide through the S's. PNK having to hold station behind Rigor there in 16th position. That's infected space. He's made a few positions since we last saw him, but not had a great start to this race. AJ's had a terrible start. We saw him banging into the barrier early on. That's it. Steph, a new driver to this league. Welcome to you in the Bentley. And that's Koenos in the N3 bringing up the back of the pack then. Back up to the front. It is difficult to know where to look. There's action here, there and everywhere. Of course, it being pretty small circuit, there's going to be action here, there and everywhere. Whew. Right, Khaki then, 2.5 seconds. Oh, and hello, I've just seen AJ and who was it? It was AJ in Dangerous Ginetta swap position. Oh, the camera's not helping me here. I'm going to have to swap from the external camera. AJ, the Dangerous Ginetta. Dangerous Ginetta must have had a problem somewhere because he's lost time on AJ. And he has got, in fact, he's braked right on his tail. So Vector's Pace trying to make his way through the pack, and he is putting pressure on the GT3 Pro Champion from Season 4. And looks like he's going to nail him in the S's. Oh, nicely done. Oh, he's overcooked it. Oh, in fact, his pace has overcooked it in the S's, and he has lost. He's just managed to get out in front of Steph and Koenos to hang on to 18th place, but he's going to have a difficult time defending that. Oh, slight nudge there from Steph. It looks like it. Oh, and Infected Space has spun. Oh, that was slightly unsportsman of Steph there to give Infected Space a bit of a nudge into the first turn. But Infected Space is away again, but unfortunately he is plum last now. Oh, the lead has changed. I've looked away at the wrong moment, and Papand in the roof has taken the lead from Khaki. Oh, goodness me. We have a lead battle then. I mean, there's battles up and down the field here. But the lead has changed. Papand in the roof has overtaken Khaki in the McLaren. So the mighty Khaki can be overtaken then. So he comes through Redgate, through Hollywood again, into the Craner curves. Just saw Tipple at the back of the shot there. Papand currently leads in these very heavy fog. I quite agree that it was a little bit late. Well, the bump draft was fine, but he should have gone out of it much earlier. So down through McLean's onto that back straight. Papin gonna have to defend the inside of Coppice. Uphill blind right-hander. Sound like, by the sound alone, it sounded like Kaki had a little bit of a cautious application of the throttle there. Papin suddenly got that lead to himself, and Kaki's not challenged into the S's. You can see the gap back to Tipple is slowly increasing, but Kaki's had a great run through the S's. He goes to the outside, Papin defending the inside into Redgate, but that's going to be brave if Kaki can swing around the outside. Oh, that's going to be close. Can Papin hang on as they go through Hollywood? He does. He does indeed. Papin hangs on to the lead through Hollywood into the Crane and Curves. Wow, great move by both Papin and Kaki then. Kaki all over the back of Papin. Goodness me, they come down McLean's, down towards... Sorry, that's Schwanz Curve. And then McLean's. Beg your pardon, get my corner names wrong. On through up the hill again, through Coppice. On to that back straight once again. Leho Jack and Franco Droz swap position. And again, it looked like, wow, look at that. It looked like Papin was able to get on the gas enough, early enough rather, to give him the breathing space he needed to prevent Kaki having a look. But can he do so on the way back through Redgate? It does look like he's got the lead he needs. Oh, but Papin's gone too deep into Redgate, and that has handed the lead straight back to Kaki. Kaki says, thank you very much, I will claim that for myself. So then, through the Crane of Curves again. Down towards Starkey's Bridge. Papin's not letting that one go at all. Up through Schwanz Curve, up the hill again. McLean's back straight towards Coppice. Dunlop straight. It goes through the corner so quick, I'm struggling to keep up. Again, these two locked in battle through the S's. Tipple still about 2.5 seconds back. He's maintaining that gap. Oh, let's just have a quick look. That's Mini Black and Enrich UK swapping positions then in the M3 and Z4. I daren't look away from this lead battle for long. The lead has already changed hands a few times. Let's just see how they do then. Back through the Crane of Curves. McLaren currently leads. We can hear that's Dangerous Ginetta is at the back then. So Dangerous Ginetta's had... is having a bad day in the office, and there we just saw Dangerous Ginetta out of shot. Sounded like he was getting away from a standing position, so he's had a spin. Dangerous Ginetta having a terrible time here at Donington. I thought the Ginetta would do pretty well here, but it seems that DG is not having a good day today. Onto that backspace yet, back straight again. Kaki leads a Papin by less than a second again. Very, very close, and that's Infected Space and Koronos, I see by the overlay. And that is DG getting out of the way of the lead two. Fair play to you, sir. It's going to be a little way down the road. Oh, but we can hear the Bentley of Steph just in the distance. What are we? It's about 7 seconds or so between Kaki and Steph. Still Papin on the gearbox of Kaki. I think they are far enough apart for me to have a look further down the field. Let's give it a little bit of time, because again, Papin is closing that gap down very, very slightly as they come through onto that back straight yet again. There we just see Steph coming out of shot. Onto that back straight. Looks like Papin's had a good run through that Coppice turn. Can he have a challenge into the S's? Might be a little bit too far back for that, but if he stays on Kaki's tail through the S's. Oh, he didn't have a good run through the S's at all. And Kaki? That's a mixture of Papin and Kaki there. So Kaki had a good run through the S's into Redgate again. Steph is going to have to be getting out of the way of this lead battle. Let's have a look through the field then. Tipple. A little bit on his own. He's got He's also overtaking Dangerous Janetta. He's got about 7 seconds ahead of him, roughly 13 back. There's Paradiski. He's coming into Redgate with Attila just behind. A little bit of a gap there, but Andrix and Mini Black still fighting between themselves as once these two, as they are side by side. Oh, and there's impact between Andrix and Mini Black. Andrix well held. Andrix held that from spinning out entirely. Wow, goodness me, that's Bacentro straight on his case. Where is Mini Black? Ah, there is Mini Black. He has allowed Andrix to retake his position. Very sporting of you, sir. Good job. That has Bacentro on your tail. And blimey, Mini Black didn't get that back for long, as he's got on the inside of Andrex to reclaim sixth position then. Andrex back into the slipstream and back on the inside again as they go onto that back straight. Centro's there getting interested as well. All the way down, side by side, down that back straight onto the S's. Oh, Andrex has braked a bit later and takes that position back again. Because of this fighting, we've got a four-chain car here. Four-chain car, good God. Mini Black then having a look on the outside. We saw Khaki have a crack at that particular maneuver, but no, the outcome was the same for Mini Black as well. We've got Centro getting interested in seventh position as well. He's right with Mini Black. That's very, very close as they come through the Craner curves. And also in that mixture, ooh, I thought that was a little bit late there. Late on the races, hey, Hojack in the roof. He is watching. Oh, and he's gone onto the infield. That's not going to help you, sir. Come on, camera. For God's sake, keep up. Just look at Attila. Try and get the... Oh, Attila's run slightly wide. Attila's run wide of compass. Mine's gone a bit quiet. Apologies there. I will try and reposition it to get that a bit better. Andrews UK still holding sixth position. Mini Black now into seventh. Centro sliding for the back. Oh, and that's... It was Mini Black. Oh, goodness me. Mini Black trying to get back onto circuit. It's earned itself a car track penalty. I thought he might do with that particular maneuver. So Mini Black earned itself a car track penalty. He is down to 10th place. So that's Wycombs that's gone up to 9th place. He's been making his way through the field. Centro in 8th and Ahojack 7th and Andrex now free of a tail in sixth position. Just jump back up to the front then, because again these two are very, very close. Is Papan gonna have a crack at the S's? No, he is not. Again, these two holding station and holding station very closely. Yeah, they've left Tipple for dead, it looks like. Let's just have a look at the best laps from these two, because I think they're very, very close. 0.005 of a second in it between the top two of Khaki and Papan. Goodness me, this battle has a long way to go. We still have a lot of laps left in this race. Let's see if these two are going to fight it out all the way. But again, if we look down the field, back of the pack, we just left. Oh, goodness me. It was that Andrex trying to get past Dangerous Janetta. It was. That's Dangerous Janetta trying to get out of the way of people that Ahojack through. As is Centro, as is Wycombs, as is Mini Black, I think. Oh, no. Sorry, the last two are not past Dangerous Janetta yet. That's adding to DG's misery. And oh, what's happened to Infected Space? Oh, is Infected Space out? He is. Infected Space has decided to retire from the race. Oh, goodness me. Well, it certainly can't be damaged, because no damage is on this particular race. Oh, dear, Infected Space. Such a shame. Very early on in the race as well. So, Paradiski 4, Attila 5, Andrews UK is 6th ahead of this 4-car train. If the camera would do something! There is Andrex. Ahojack fending off Centro. So Andrex has actually broken off from this 4-car train. Wycombs and Mini Black. Mini Black at the back of it now, as opposed to at the front. Reichel's just sort of 11 to AJ. That's Dangerous Janetta getting out of the way. AJ up to 11 in the roof. Rygor in the roof, 12. Groby in the McLaren, 13. Franco drove in the Franco Droz in the Sol Aston Martin, just coming down to the S's in 14th position. Vice Guy fending off, that's PNK in 15th position. PNK having a look on the inside, was the S's, does he do so, does he not? That's too wide. Vice Guy giving him the room, and he's overcooked it. Vice Guy overcooked it slightly and has given 15th to PNK. Kowanos in the M3s around there somewhere. Come on, camera, keep up. There we go. There is Kouanos and Steph having their battle in 17th position. And Dangerous Janetta, as we've seen, getting lap. But Mini Black and Wycombs in fourth position now. Unfortunately, I just saw the overlay change. I didn't see the maneuver itself. But Mini Black has gone one step up in this four-car chain, displacing Wycombs. Let's head back up to the front then, as Khaki and Papan still locked in this battle. Apologies there, ladies and gentlemen. I just had to put my microphone down for a second and shut the door behind me. Oh, now what's happened to Steph? Steph must have spun at some point, because he is, assuming it's a male Steph, apologies, I just realised. Danger Janetta has claimed that 18th position and is... I was going to say he's on Franco Droz's case, but just realised Franco Droz has lapped DG. Still, Khaki holding off Papan, less than a second between the two. Tipple on his own, just coming across the line to complete lap 19. Sorry, to start lap 19, big pardon. I think. Yes, to start lap 19. Ooh, and that's Attila with Paradiski on his tail. Paradiski's having a great race today. Andrew Duquet's having a good old time too. So, heading down to Red Gate, that's Attila going for a slightly more defensive line with Paradiski. Roof holding off Z4. Z4 is really putting the pressure on. Paradiski's having a great day. And so that's 12th position that's just changed hand. Groby's had a good drive. Did Vigo have a cut track penalty as Groby has flown past him and claimed 12th position. The highest climbers we have in this race so far are Andrex and Paradiski. There goes Paradiski, and in a moment, there goes Andrex, and the camera's still looking in the wrong place. There we go. Paradiski, Attila, and that's Kouanos in the N3 getting out of the way. Good job, well done to you, Attila, then. And Paradiski on that back straight. Paradiski, he's lost time on Attila somewhere around the lap. And that's Kouanos slotting into position. We have Andrew UK just gone through the S's. He's got distance fore and aft. And Nice guy, and Franco Droz having a bit of a battle, and again, the camera's lost. Oh, that's why the Aston Martin was on the infield. As has the way that his car swings around makes me think he's driving on a keyboard. I don't know how the hell you play this game on a keyboard, I really don't. But fair play to you. So, Weissguy then on his own in 15th position. We'll jump back up to the battles we were previously seeing, and Khaki and Papan, and Khaki was on the infield of the S's. Khaki's had a very rare mistake. He's handed the lead back to Papan again, and Papan continues. Where is he? He's got himself a 4-odd second lead, and a back marker in between, oh, over 4 seconds now, over six seconds between himself and Khaki. Can Papan disappear off into the distance? Oops, and that's, who was that? That was PNK getting out of the way there of leader Papan. There we see Papan coming through. As Dangerous Janetta again ahead of him. And DG going to the inside there as Papan goes up towards Coppice. He is on his own then with Khaki from fending his way through the back markers. He's just gone through Coppice himself. Onto the back straight. Tipple then. Where is he? There he is. So he's gaining time on Khaki, of course, but not enough to be challenging for position. Attila still has Paradiski for company. It's the closest battle we have, closest towards the front. So Paradiski and Attila still locked in a battle. On board with Paradiski as we come through Coppice onto that back straight. Paradiski taking a wider line initially through that corner, but not gaining him the traction he needs as Attila gets slight enough of a gap to prevent Paradiski getting a decent drive through before the S's. That is that Andrex? Yep, that's Andrex UK we just saw behind them. Through they come to complete lap 21. And that's Mini Black in centre swapping position then. Mini Black and the Z4 getting the better of the AMG Mercedes. Oh, and that's Kohanos trying to get out of the way. Flash of lights there by Mini Black to remind Kohanos that he needs to be getting out of the way, and he was doing his best to do so. Centro and Wycombs, and the camera is lost again, and Wycombs is on the infield, probably trying to avoid Kohanos there. Oh, and he's gone slightly wide. That's through the grainer curves. And of course, the camera is lost again. Oh, Zatilla running slightly wide there at Coppice. I'm not entirely certain, but could be just a slightly different line that he has chosen to use. Down that back straight once again. Just realising the microphone's
gone a little quiet again.
Apologies there, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, and look at this. Apparently he's right with the tiller now. Can he get a decent run to Redgate? No, Attila does a good defensive line, but he's gone very deep. Oh, can Paradisi capitalise on this? Paradisi got the inside line. Can he get the power down? No, Attila just manages to get the traction he needs to keep that
fourth place to himself. Great, great stuff.
Oh, but is that going to be wide? No, he just manages to hang on to it. Paradisi putting pressure on the whole time to get that fourth position from Attila. They come up towards Coppice again, Attila just running a little bit wide, but Paradisi not able to, sorry, I beg your pardon, this is Coppice, they've just come up the hill, blind right-hander again, and Paradisi right with him now, great bit of slipstreaming, can Paradisi do something about it? Attila going to the inside, Paradisi still with him, but no, oh, that's forced Paradisi to go to the outside. That's going to lose a bit of time. We can see Andrex is... Oh, Attila's overcooked it! Attila has overcooked it in the S's. He's lost that fifth position to Andrex UK. And the pressure from Paradisi has paid off. The Z4 through to fourth position. And is away with Andrex UK claiming fifth. Attila just manages to slide into sixth position before Mini Black at him. So then Attila now has a different Z4 on his tail. This time of Mini Black. Mini Black has no lights on. Oh, he's just, beg your pardon, he's just very, very dim. Aho Jack in the roof, fending off Centro in the Merc, with Wycombs not far behind in the Bentley. AJ slightly on his own in the roof. Rygor in his roof. He's quite a bit further back, he's just coming through the grainer curves. And that's Papan we can hear coming up behind him to put a lap on him. As Centro and Aho Jack in sweet position. There is Centro, there is Aho Jack. So somewhere just before McLean's, Aho Jack has lost out that 8th position to the Mercedes. That's an unusual overtaking spot, I will say. You can see how close it is as they come through the S's. Mini Black putting pressure on Attila. And Stefan Dangerous Ginetta swapping positions again. And it looks like we've lost... Oh, Infected Space has decided to leave the session. That's a shame. A great shame that we lost Infected Space from the game. Did Dangerous Ginetta retire? No, Dangerous Ginetta is still running. As I've confused the camera. There is Mini Black again, still on the tail of Attila. And what's happened here? Where's Andrex gone? Andrex has had a moment somewhere, because he's suddenly down to 7th. Mini Black, Attila. That's, who's that? That's Steph that's just getting out of the way on the back straight there. There's Mini Black. Oh, that could have been nasty, but well done, Steph, for avoiding Mini Black as well. And managed to get out of Andrex's way, and Centro's. Good job. Good job. Let's jump up back to the front of the field. Let's see how our leader's doing. Papand. He's just on that back straight, isn't he? Yes, he is. Heading down toward the yeses again as we are fast approaching the halfway stage in this race. There, that's a roof. I was just about to say that is a Khaki just behind. It isn't. That is Khaki. Khaki has closed the gap a little, but still the upper hand remains with Papan in the roof. Oh, hello, Mini Black and Attila have swapped position. So the pressure from another Z4 has pushed Attila down another spot. Mini Black claiming fifth position from Attila. Paradiski still on his own in fourth position. There he is, just coming onto the back straight. So he's got distance fore and aft. Tipple is also on his own. There he is, cuts the crane and curves. If the camera would look in the right place, there we go. That's where they are on the map. That is, where is that? That's Stansky's Bridge, Schwanzkurve, I was right. Now McLean's. Ooh, that looked like quite a tail happy roof there from Tipple. And it looks like Paradiski. Oh no, Paradiski's about half a lap behind. He's just started the lap, but I thought he was reining him in then. So Paradiski then coming through the granite curve. We have Mini Black. Where is he? Come on, camera, keep up. There he is. He's not been able to shake Attila to a great degree, but Attila now has Andrex on his tail. Andrex is certainly learning how to be defensive as he's constantly got someone on his tail. There we just see Mini Black coming through the shot with Attila then all running slightly wide as they head up to Coppice. Z4, roof, M3, and that's Mercedes just behind up Centro. Andrex a decent amount of positions up from where he started. On that back straight, can he do something about the roof ahead of him? Not this time. That's a four-car train just coming through the S's then. Through they come to start lap 28. Centro looking on at the back of this train with Wycombs in the Bentley, losing touch with this train slightly. AJ in his roof, trying to catch the Bentley ahead. Ahojek just coming through Redgate. Rygor, that's Kharki we see coming through the picture. Rygor getting out of the way of race either. There's Dangerous Janetta again. Still continuing to drag his Janetta around this circuit. Groby in the other McLaren. There's PNK in the Z4. Coming through Redgate. Franco Droz in the Aston coming through the S's. Vice Guy in his roof. He's rather on his own position wise. Coming down the back straight, but he has got that's Mini Black, Attila, and Andrex around him. Oh, just behind him, I should say. So he'll be. He's decided to go through the infield. Probably take a contract penalty and allow those lead cars through. Koenos, as we've previously seen, he's around there somewhere. Camera is lost once more. Steph. And I'm assuming that's Vice Guy returning to second. Nope, not sure who that was. Oh, Attila and Andrex are getting a little bit keen as they're too wide through the crane curves. Oh, goodness me. So Andrex managed to nose ahead of Attila then. Oh, and Attila's run slightly wide at the end of the crane curves. That's given Andrex a position, opportunity rather. But no, the roof manages to keep the M3 at bay just. Only just, though. No, Neptune, no one has pitted yet. Oh, as we see now that Centro is closing in on this quarreling duo. Very, very close. That's the backstreet that they are now on. Let's go on board with Andrex. Can he make an inside maneuver under the S's? Ooh, that's close. I wouldn't want to be sitting where this camera is, I tell you. Onto the start finish straight yet again. As we hit the halfway stage in this race, 30 laps. Well, they started lap 30, I beg your pardon. 29 laps down, 31 to go, so we're approaching the halfway stage out of this race. Still, Andrew GK trying to force his way through past the roof. And we see Centro's lost. Centro's retired. Oh no, Centro's pitted, I beg your pardon. First pit of the day. It is Centro in the Mercedes. He is in the pits. He is going to be doing what assumes his sole pit stop of the day. And away he goes. Where does he reappear? Out he comes. I love the fact that the light goes green after you've passed it. He appears in 12th, just behind the lap runner, Koenos. Back up through the field then. Papand. I think he's actually just gone through camera. There goes... There he is. There is Papo. We just saw Kharki go through the shot. That is... where is that? That's the back straight, so that's just, they've just come through Coppice. down the back straight. We haven't seen the leaders in the pits as yet. Not that I don't believe so. Oh, hello. Many Black and Paradiski getting in the mix. Frisky here. That's Paradiski's lost that fourth position to the others in for a Mini Black as they come through. Coppice. No, it's not. That's the credit curves. I beg your pardon. Wrong end of the lap. Z4 on Z4. Mini Black overtaking Paradiski for fourth place. Oh, but Paradiski's having a look. That's not a normal overtaking spot, but Paradiski's having a crack nonetheless as they come through Sharan's corner up to McLean's. Oh, Mini Black forcing Paradiski there the long way around and capitalizing on it, but Paradiski is nailed to Mini Black's gearbox. They come through. Coppice again onto that back straight. Paradiski taking a much narrower line through the last part of that turn. Up they come then towards the S's, and Paradiski remains behind Mini Black at this stage. Any more pitters? Tipple still out. Khaki and Papan still going. Oh, sounds like someone's hit the wall. Didn't get an idea of who. Nope, no idea. Papan continues. Pit entrance we've just seen there on the left. On the left of the circuit, the right of the image. Khaki with who's that vice guy nailed on his nailed in front of him, I think. Oh no, it's Aho Jack. Wait, come on. We have got pitters in though, I think. Tipple. Paradiski's regained fourth somewhere along the line. Where's Mini Black gone? We've lost Mini Black entirely. Oh goodness me! Mini Black has gone from the session. Oh dear! What a shame. We had a great battle of the Z4s forming there. Andrews UK in the M3's got breathing space four and a half. AJ in the roof. Slightly on his own. Wycombs in the Bentley's obviously promoted another position. On that back straight then. There's a Hojack in the roof. Just coming around Coppice, getting onto that back straight himself. Weigel in the roof. Very, very slow. Okay. Did Weigel get a cut track penalty? It's a weird place to get a cut track penalty, but he is going again. Centro in the Merc with Steph ahead of him in the Bentley. Steph getting out of the way. There he goes. Attila. Here's a falling down the order again. That's what's happening to Paradiski. Where is Paradiski? Wait, is Paradiski? That's why Paradiski in the pits. That was a quick stop. Quick stop for Paradiski, and away he goes again. Also, Paradiski's in around 11th, 12th somewhere. 11th position he comes. There he is. We see Franco Droz here in the Aston. Still in 12th. Vice Guy 13. I think Vice Guy's been through the pits at some stage as well. Koenos in his M3 just coming up to Coppice. Steph. With who's that behind him? That's Attila behind him. Benji Ginetta out there on his own. PNK has retired from the race. We have 16 runners remaining then. PNK is out and Groby is out. And of course, I am still there. Back into the order then. We are back with Papand as he is coming onto the. Where is he? He's coming through the Carina curves. We've just seen Weigel gain a position from a Hojack because a Hojack is in the pits then in the roof, having his sole pit stop on lap 35. Centro has just gone past. Where does a Hojack appear? Attila goes through. Paradiski is also through. So out he comes in 11th position then. There's a big gap time wise at 11th spot. Out comes a Hojack again with no lights on either. That could be something that may have to be addressed, as it really does, particularly the silver cars. It makes them very, very hard to see. And that dangerous Ginetta getting slightly caught out there through the Craner curves. In AO Jack's way. That's Paradiski working his way past Steph. Attila is around there somewhere. There we go, just through the shot there. Oh, the wonderful sound glitch yet again. Hello there, Benny boy. Hello, welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for coming along. Let's jump back onto the front then. Papand, where is he? Where is he? He's coming to the end of the Granny curves. Indeed, indeed. Remember, we are down to one lap times tyre wear. It is possible for people to no-stop it if they are careful with their tyres. Or leave their stop very, very late. So Papan then, as he heads down towards Coppice, through Coppice rather, he is on his own to the tune of, it's about anywhere between 4 and 5 seconds. So Kaki has been gnawing away at that lead slowly but surely, but not able to make a massive inroad into the lead that Papan has after his cut penalty here at the Etis some time ago. Tipple holds third, where he's been pretty much all race long. He's just coming through Coppice onto that back straight, so he's quite some way behind the lead pair. Andrex UK, where is he? He's on the corner curve somewhere, I assume. Yes, he is. Oops, that's Franco Droz and the Aston getting out of the way. There's going to be a lot of that due to the nature of the circuit. So that's Andrex UK with Vice Guy ahead of him. Vice Guy trying to find a spot to get out of the way. Coming up to Coppice then. Vice Guy's still there. AJ then has been making his way through the field. He is now in fifth in the roof. Off of Coppice onto that back straight again. Wycombs in the Bentley. He's on his own. 10 seconds behind sixth place AJ. Rygor in the roof. We've just seen him go through shot because the camera's lost again. Up to Coppice. Through he goes, and he again's on his own, and he's got a cut track penalty again as he comes onto the infield. Did he get a cut track penalty, or did he just overcook it and get onto the infield? Not entirely sure what happened there with Rygor, but he is going again. Centro then onto that back straight. He could be, is he going to be claiming Rygor? Oh, I hate that sound glitch. Attila then in the roof was running inside seventh, but a few mistakes later, and he is down in ninth position. Paradiski, after his pit stop, he is now in 10th. Comes through the S's. Oh, and that's AJ in the pits then. AJ is making his pit stop. Paradiski comes through. Out comes AJ. Relatively short pit stop here. Very, very short pit straight. And 11th position out. He comes in just behind a Hojak. Again, you see, oh, there go the lights. So there you see the difference, how it illuminates, particularly that silver roof. The light on and the light off. There's Vice Guy just coming past Dangerous Ginetta coming into Redgate with Andrex UK directly ahead of him. Franco Droz, the Soul Aston Martin 13th, just coming down to Redgate himself. Coronos in the M3, that's the back straight heading down towards the Essex. That's Steph in the Bentley. He is coming through. I've forgotten. That's McLean's. He's just gone through. Beg your pardon. On to down towards Coppice, and he's in the back straight. He hasn't got the Dangerous Ginetta in the middle of a field of people ahead of him. Oh, Attila has just overtaken Rygor, I see, and that's because Rygor's in the pit. So Rygor's having a pit stop then. Paradiski goes through. Hojak goes through. Does AJ claim him as well? Yes, he will. So Rygor then gets that 11th post-pit stop space. Away goes the roof of Rygor. So feel relatively spaced out as far as battles are concerned, but there's cars here, there and everywhere, which could upset the balance somewhat. We head back up at the top of the field. We see Papan then. Where is he? Let's have a look on where he is. Whoops, that's not the right thing to click. He is coming through the Craning Curves. So he's on lap 40 out of 60. So 21 laps to go. As he is coming up to, who's that ahead of him? That's Rygor, a fellow roof driver ahead of him, running in the same Rygor's, running the same roof strip. Through the old hairpin, down towards, sorry, the bigger bump, that's through McLean's, up to Coppice, round they come, onto that back straight. So I'm looking at the best laps, is it still 5,000 between the top two? Not quite. Papan getting us another few thousands on Kaki. 19,000 in it. And there we see Kaki in the background, able to get a massive amount, and in comes Papan. Race leader Papan comes into the pits then for his stop Does Kharki do the same? No, he does not. So Kharki regains the lead then. What can he do with this? Does he pit a lap later? Does he try to go much, much further? We will see. Papan, where will he reappear? Who knows, who knows? Tipple's still a few seconds behind. There is Tipple. And we can hear Papan just getting up to speed then. There goes Tipple through into second. And out comes Papan. Oh, and that was, who was that, PNK? Centro, beg your pardon, it was Centro and the Mercedes. Just happened to be in the same spot as Papan when he was coming out. So then, Papan on the chase again to regain that lead. Where's Kharki? There he is, just coming through the S-Bends. Whoa, he's overdone it and he's clouted the Bentley of Steph. That's not going to help his race at all. So the tyres a bit second-hand then by this stage. A small mistake in the S is where he came across it before. And Attila and Centro again are having a crack at one another. Where's Centro? There he is. So Attila has left him for dead. So Centro at some stage has made a bit of a mistake and left himself. Well, he's been left rather behind. He's on the back straight then. As Attila comes through the S's and continues. Where is Kharki? There he is. That is Swamps. No, that's the McLean's turn. Oh, you hear a bit of an impact there. Unfortunately, I can't see who it was that had a bit of a bump. Onto the back straight again for the McLaren. Does he pit this time? And Papan beginning to wheel Tipple in. It looks like Papan has gone around the outside of Tipple, through up to McLean's. What a move that was. It could be that Tipple decided to allow Papan through. I'm not sure Tipple's pitted yet, but either way, it was pretty brave racing maneuver there for Papan to claim Tipple around the outside as he comes onto the back straight then. Has Kharki pitted? No, he has not. Kharki down that back straight again, heading towards the S's. What is the time gap between them? We will know when Papan crosses the line. See how much time he has to make up from Kharki. It is, when it updates, 30 seconds. So there is a 30 second gap from Kharki to Papan, from McLaren to Ruth. Let's see what happens in the next 18 laps as Ahojek has lost a position. Now Tipple's decided to pit now. That's a pretty good idea. Andrex and Ahojek have swapped positions. Where's Ahojek gone? There he is. I think he's just come out of the pits. It was AJ that had gone past him. Let's see who else we can find there. Paradiski and Centro beginning to get a bit closer now. Paradiski has been, after his pit stop, has been making his way back through the field. Can he claim this position from the Mercedes then? Also, another battle we can look at is Andrex and Tipple, as Tipple has come out in third position with the N3 right behind him. There is Tipple, there is Andrex with Rival in the middle for company as well. Where is that? That is McLean's, they're just coming up to him. On towards Coppice. Up they come. Oh dear, that's not going to help. Tipple's gone. Tipple's not handled that one well at all. He's gone very, very slow there. Did he incur a stop penalty, a cut penalty? I don't know. But Andrex has claimed third position from Tipple. M3 has taken the roof. Oh, but he's overcooked it in the S's. Does he come in? No, he does not. Andrex continues. Overcooked in the S's. That has allowed Tipple to close the gap up again. Well, practice makes perfect, they say, Mr. Neptune. That's Tipple right with Andrex UK then for third position. Will Andrex try and fight the roof off? Let us see. They come through the old hairpin down towards Starkey's Bridge. Oh, and that's Tipple right with the M3. Schmanz curve. McLean's. Ooh, so close to impact. Up towards Coppice again.
Through they come onto that back straight. This will be Tipple's best opportunity to claim the N3. Tipple has a much tighter line. Onto the inside he comes. And through he goes. Tipple reclaims that third position from Andrex. Through the S's they come. And that's Kharki. That looks like Kharki behind them. That's because it is Kharki behind them. Kharki still yet to pit. They come through Red Gate again. And there is race leader Kharki. He's lapped everybody up to Mycon's in fifth place. Wow. That's not a great place to try and get out of the race leader's way. And there goes the McLaren on the inside of the M3. And that is fourth position then that's been lapped by the charging Kharki. It is highly possible, Yuzhnikov, that Kharki is not stopping. Onto the back straight yet again. Well, it would take some doing to do 60 laps on a set of softs, but the ambient temperature is not very high because of the fog. I guess it is possible. Who's that? Tipple's come across with somewhere because Andrex is back in third again. I didn't see exactly what happened to Tipple there, but he's back in fourth. He's lost out to Andrex again. Now, is Andrex having a defensive maneuver? It looks like he's allowed Tipple to come through. By the look of that, it looked like Andrex allowed Tipple to go through there. So Tipple go back into third position. We've just seen Kharki go through the shot. Where is Papand? There he is, just coming through Redgate. Let's close that gap up slightly with 14 laps to go and 27 seconds of lead to close down. And again, Andrex still with Tipple then. For third position, we see AJ and Paradiski have swapped positions. Let's have a look. Oh, look at that! On the inside of, where's that? That was on the inside of Redgate. Paradiski and AJ still side by side as they come through the corner curves. Oh, Paradiski has claimed that seventh position as his own. What a move. AJ still trying to get on the outside of the Z4, but to no avail. Paradiski has got that position for himself. Great maneuver there. And Paradiski, he's been having a great race today. AJ then. Oh, the camera's confused. Let's jump on board with AJ as he comes up through Coppice. This will be an interesting camera to use. Let's just use that one. No, actually, let's use the other one. I was right. Onto the back straight. Can AJ get the slipstream on the Z4? It's not a particularly long straight to do it. He's gaining. He's gone to the inside. He's gone for a late break maneuver. And he has got him. Super the position. Back to AJ. What a move. Can Paradiski claim him on the inside of Redgate? AJ getting very defensive. Forcing Paradiski. So AJ holding seventh as they come through Redgate into the Crainer Curves again. Single body win now the Crainer Curves. Paradiski not letting that one go at all. Papin needs 2 seconds of that. Doable, but that's going to be very, very hard work. Even it's going to need Kharki's tyres to go completely to mush. Paradiski's had a problem somewhere because he was right with AJ and he's lost out big time. And the camera's lost. Oh, such a shame. It was a great battle then, but unfortunately Paradiski has made a mistake somewhere and now has a Hojak for company. On board with a Hojak as they come back onto the back straight. Paradiski is sufficiently ahead to prevent a Hojak from making a move there. Oh, a Hojak didn't have a good run through the S's then in the roof. Through they come to complete and run out. As the field spaces out again. Unfortunately, the timings are quite confused in the rear. It's just many people in the same lane as one another. Here is Kharki again, race leader of the McLaren. Continues on.
Lap 50 into Redgate. There is Papand coming into the S's. What is the time gap between them? It is. With 11 laps remaining, the gap is under 22 seconds. Even at 2 seconds a lap, that is going to be a monumental effort. There's about half a second now between Papin's best and Kaki's best. It is going to be an incredible effort by Papin to close that gap in time, unless, of course, Kaki pits, but all indications would be that he is not going to do so. Tipple then in third, with Rygaard already ahead of him into the S's. There is Kaki, we see in the background, trying to lap third place. Rygaard getting out of the way of Tipple as they come into Redgate. Andrus UK, he's coming into Redgate then. Attila, around there somewhere. Here he is, coming onto the back straight again. Centro, in the Mercedes, on his own. AJ, confused camera once more. On that back straight once more. Paradiski, can he close that gap to AJ Core? He's had another. He's had another terrible run, as he's now a good 5-6 seconds back from AJ. What's happened to you? Let's just see where Kaki is. There is Kaki. Bear in mind, he hasn't pitted yet. He's on that back straight. Last lap, 105. Best 103.823. Through he comes again. Papand. Wrong click again. Let's see where, what the timing is. So what's the time gap between the two? 21 again, so Papin not able to close that gap to Kaki, and he's running out of laps to do so. 9 to go. Just 9 laps here at the Donington Park National Circuit. Only the top two on the same lap. And oh, that looks like Kohanos going for a trip on the grass to try and get out of the way of second place Papin. That's one way to do it. Let's see if we can find a battle. Centro and AJ are pretty close together. Let's have a look. There's Centro in 6th position. And that's AJ you just saw behind. Not as close as I would have liked. Let's have a look at Ahojek and Rygaard. There is Ahojek and there is Rygaard. And the roof in front of them is actually 3rd place Tipple. You look at the relative board, you have 8th, followed by 15th, followed by 3rd, followed by 9th, followed by 10th, followed by 1st, followed by 4th. So that just goes to tell you how mixed up the field currently is. Oh, and that's a very sideways Tipple then in 3rd position. Ahojek possibly looking to unlap himself. No, he's decided to stay behind 3rd place Tipple as they come through onto, that's through McLean's up to Coppice. And now Ahojek has definitely got Rygaard for company as they come through Coppice again onto that back straight. 8 laps remaining. Straight, there's the S's once more. Oh, Ahojek's gone very, very deep under the entrance of the S's. That's going to put Rygaard right in his tail. And Ahojek has lost the position to Rygaard. Overcooked into the and through the S's, and Rygaard retakes a 9th position for himself. Oh, and there's Kaki trying to get past Ahojek. Through Redgate, through Hollywood. Greener curves again. To the old hairpin. There's Rygaard, there is Ahojek and Kaki. Where did Kaki go? Has Kaki had a problem? Kaki was right there and he's lost time. He's definitely lost time. That lead is halved. Now then, Kaki's come a cropper and has allowed Papand to close in quite considerably. Ooh, now is Kaki running out of tyres? Is he regretting that
no. Is he regretting that no? Can't get my sentences out. I'm trying to read what you guys are saying. Is he regretting the no-stop decision? There goes Kharki. There is Papand. Less than... That's about 10 seconds out, 1 point. So then, big, big time loss then for Kharki. What is it at the end of this lap? 6 laps to go. The lead is down to 9 seconds. Oh, goodness me. If we just look at the last laps... Oh, typical. It doesn't tell us what Kharki's last lap was, but because he clunked into the barrier or maybe accidentally cut somewhere. So Papand, if he gets on a bit of a mission, if Kharki has another problem, the lead could change once again in the closing stages of this race. As Kharki comes down, where is that? That is down the back straight. No, it's not. It's coming through. Comes through Coppice onto the Dunlop straight again. Ooh, it looked very squirrely coming through Coppice. I think he's struggling for grip now. I bet you Papand is flooring it. Onto that back straight, into the S's again. And just see what that lap was from Kharki. Through he comes to complete another lap. Making it 5 to go. What was that last lap? Why 5? What is Papand's lap then? As he's coming through the start from this line, that lap for Papand, 1:03.8. So 1.5 seconds to Papand's advantage then. Could he do it? Ooh, it's going to be very, very close, but it looks like Kharki is struggling to get the power into the black stuff from those tyres. I'm not surprised, there's very little tyre left. This is going to get juicy as the race comes to a close. 5 laps to go. Through McLean's comes Kharki. He's got Steph, Ahojek and Rigel ahead of him. Cautiously, cautious through Coppice once again. Ooh, again, you can see he's gone onto the rumble strip again. That may not help his cause. We look back at Papand. Oh, he's got Andres UK ahead of him, but Andres getting out of the way. Both of them on that start from the straight then. Oh, just as I say that, on that back straight, rather not start from the straight. Here comes Kharki to start lap 57. What was his last lap? It was a 105.4. You can see the pace difference between the McLaren and the roof. That's another 1.3 seconds for Papand. He was slightly held up by backmarkers. 4 laps to go. We're watching Kharki then. Oh, he's gone slightly wide there. Where was that? That was coming through the old hairpin. To McLean's, and that's Steph in the Bentley directly ahead of Kharki. That won't help him at all. Coming up to Coppice once again. Oh, that's a terrible place to have a backmarker as well. Oh dear, that's going to help Papand, I think, close that gap up. Or it could help give Kharki a bit of a draft. Oh, that's going to be closer than the S. He does make it to. He does manage to slow that car down into the S's. Through they come. And complete lap 57 for Kharki. What was that lap time? Let's have a look again. 105.2, slightly quicker. Papand then, here he comes. Last lap, 103.7 again, 1.5 seconds. Papand, I think he is going to run out of time. He is going to need a problem for Kharki. There you see Steph in the background in that shot. Oh, that's dangerous. Janetta and Ahojek, you just see that, tripping over one another. Angel Janetta staying well out of the way of Kharki there, as Kharki is coming up to McLean's once again. Well, you can see on the map there, you can't really see the arrow, but the arrow is coming to that last corner complex at the bottom left of the map, and the green dot is Papand. So round comes Kharki, onto that back straight again. We can hear Ahojek directly ahead of the McLaren. Oh, that's too deep. That's too deep into the S's. That's not going to help Kharki in the slightest. Through they come then. 2 laps remaining. What was the lap time for Kharki? 106.3. And for Papand, 104.3. So 2 seconds for Papand then. Less than 3 seconds between the pair of them. There, you just saw Papand in that shot. Didn't see him in that particular shot as they come through the greater cast to the penultimate time. Will Kharki win this race? I think pretty much every social race I've commentated on, Kharki has won, but he is going to have to fight for this one. As a Papin is closing him down hand over fist as they're coming up to the old hairpin, through Schwantz, through McLean's. Looked like he was a little bit cautious there, but of course that is dangerous. Ginetta's engine tone we can hear. Through Coppice once more, onto that back straight. Bouncing over that rumble strip, down that back straight. There's the S's again. Bit more control. There's Papand! There is Papand, you can see! The gap is less than 2 seconds as we enter the final lap then. 105.8 for Kharki. Let's just keep on this. 103.8 for Papand. There's 2 seconds to Papand's advantage. And the gap is less than 2 seconds now. If Papand gains another 2 seconds, he will gain this race. Dangerous Janetta gets out of the way. Let's actually watch on board with Papand. There is Kharki. That is less than 1.5 seconds. They're coming through. I'm lost where we are. Kharki's coming up to McLean for the final time. Kharki having to break very, very early on that short straight down to, well, up to Coppice. Look at that! If Papand can get a good drive, and you can see how Kharki is struggling. Papand is in the slipstream. His one and only chance is into the S's. He's gone onto the inside. Can he do it? Oh, is it Papand between the two? Oh, goodness me. That's going to force Kharki onto the infield. And Kharki is, sorry, Papand's allowing. No, Papand is going to the line. It looks like he's going to give Kharki the victory. Oh, goodness me. Kharki takes the race win. Oh, goodness me. That was a little bit anticlimactic finish to the race, but what a sport for Papand. He could have taken that. He could have taken the race win, but he handed it back to Kharki. So your race winner then for here at Donington Park is this man, Kharki, once again claiming the race win. Second is the roof of Papand. Third place, barely got to see anyone else. Andrix UK is across the line in third position in the M3. AJ is currently showing in fourth, but I'm not sure whether that's because of the... but there we go. And AJ is now falling through the order. Oh, third place. Apologies, is Tipple. Of course, the ordering gets completely messed up, as we all know. But with everyone being on very different laps, it's going to be impossible to announce where people are until everybody has come to rest. So here comes... I think that's the last of the cars coming across the line. It's probably Dangerous Ginetta crawling up to the line there. So, everyone should be in the correct position then. Kharki 1, Papand 2 as they come into the pits. Tipple 3, Andrews UK 4, AJ 5, Attila in 6th position. Parandisky finally finishing in 7, Centro 8, Ahojek 9, Rygor rounds out your top 10. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching me this evening. My name is King Kodiak, and I will see you next time here for AOR GT3 League Racing. Thank you very much, and good night.